In the PreTrig review part 14, we go over how to do polynomial long division and synthetic division. Let's take a look at example A, and we have x minus 2 being divided into 4x cubed minus 10x squared plus 3x plus 5. Now we know that x can go into 4x cubed, and the exponent would be x squared. The coefficient, since we have a 1 there and we need a 4 here, will be a 4. So we have 4x squared, and we have to take that times the x minus 2. So 4x squared times x would be 4x cubed. 4x squared times a minus 2 would be minus 8x squared. Now we have to subtract that whole quantity. So 4x cubed minus 4x cubed cancels out. A minus 10x squared, and then this turns into plus 8x squared is minus 2x squared. And then we bring down the 3x. Now we know that x will go into minus 2x squared. We have to multiply times minus 2x. And now we have minus 2x times x is minus 2x squared. We have minus 2x times a minus 2 is plus 4x. And then we have to subtract. Minus 2x squared plus 2x squared cancels out. 3x minus 4x is negative x. And then we bring down the 5. Now we see we need to multiply by a minus 1. We've got minus 1 times x is minus x. Minus 1 times a minus 2 is a plus 2. And we have to subtract that whole thing. The negative x plus x cancels out. And the 5 minus 2 is 3. And this, of course, is our remainder. So that comes up here as plus 3 over x minus 2. So then this is our solution. Now, you can do this very quickly using what's called synthetic division. And in synthetic division, what we do is we can put just the coefficients, 4, negative 10, positive 3, and positive 5. And over here, what we do is put whatever number would make the denominator a 0. And of course, that number would be a 2. Now, the first order of business in synthetic division is that first coefficient always just comes straight down, so that will be a 4. Now what we do is take 2 times 4, which is 8, add it to the negative 10, and we get minus 2. Then we take 2 times negative 2 is negative 4. Negative 4 plus 3 is negative 1. 2 times a negative 1 is negative 2. Negative 2 plus 5 is equal to 3. And what happens is this gives you the coefficients of what's called the depressed polynomial. Since your original polynomial started with an x cubed and you were dividing by an x, you know that your first exponent will be x squared. So that tells you that this is 4x squared minus 2x minus 1, and that your remainder is a 3. Now you can see how this relates to the long division, but we had to write a lot less. Let's take a look at example B and do the synthetic division first. So we write down our coefficients, 2, 3, negative 10, 2, and 15. And the number that makes the denominator equal to 0 is negative 3. So that's what we'll do the synthetic division with. The first coefficient comes straight down. So we have a 2. And now we do multiplication with addition. So we multiply, negative 3 times 2 is negative 6, and then we add it to the 3. Negative 6 plus 3 is negative 3. Here we have negative 3 times negative 3 is 9. Take away 10, minus 1. Negative 3 times negative 1 is 3. Add 2, we get 5. Negative 3 times 5 is negative 15, plus 15 is 0. So that's our remainder. Our remainder worked out to be 0. Now because the numerator had a degree 4, and we were dividing by an x, we know that our depressed polynomial will begin with degree 3. So this tells us that we're going to have 2x cubed minus 3x squared minus x plus 5 is our quotient. Now let's take a look at the long division and see how it compares. So we would have x plus 3 dividing into 2x to the fourth plus 3x cubed minus 10x squared plus 2x plus 15. So our first multiplier will be 2x cubed. So 2x cubed times x is 2x to the fourth. 2x cubed times 3 is going to be 6x cubed, and then we have to subtract. The first two terms here cancel out. We've got 3x cubed minus 6x cubed is a negative 3x cubed, and we bring down the minus 10x squared. Our next multiplier is going to be a negative 3x squared. So we've got to multiply times the divisor here. So negative 3x squared times x, negative 3x cubed. Negative 3x squared times 3 is going to be minus 9x squared. And then we subtract. These two cancel out. And then we have negative 10x squared plus 9x squared is negative x squared. And we bring down the plus 2x. Now our multiplier is going to be negative x, so that we have negative x times x is negative x squared. We've got negative x times 3 is minus 3x, and we subtract. These two cancel, 2x and then plus 3x is 5x. We bring down the 15. And now our multiplier is going to be a positive 5. And we have 5 times x is 5x. And 5 times 3 is 15. We subtract and see that our remainder is 0. Now, because the remainder was 0, that means that the denominator is actually a factor of the numerator. So this actually would factor out to be x plus 3 times 2x cubed minus 3x squared minus x plus 5, and of course the divisor x plus 3. Let's take a look at example C. We know the first step is to write down our coefficients. So we have 4, negative 8, negative 5, and 4. Now in the denominator we have 2x minus 1, and we want to rewrite that as 2 times x minus 1/2. You want to make the leading coefficient here of the x a 1. And then it's really easy to see that what makes this a 0 is 1/2. So in the synthetic division, the first coefficient comes straight down. Now we take 1/2 times 4, which is 2, subtract 8, and we get negative 6. Half of negative 6 is negative 3, minus 5, negative 8. Half of negative 8 is negative 4, plus 4 is 0. This tells us that our depressed polynomial is 4x squared minus 6x minus 8. And because the remainder is 0, we know that the x minus 1/2 is a factor. Now, remember though, we were doing division by 2x minus 1. So let's see how we have to handle that. The way this would factor is we would have x minus 1/2 times 4x squared minus 6x minus 8. So what we're going to do here is multiply this first factor times 2, and we're going to multiply this second factor times 1/2. So to be very clear, what we're actually multiplying is 1, because 2 times 1/2 is equal to 1. But that helps us, because what we get now is 2x minus 1, right? 2 times x minus 2 times 1/2 is 2x minus 1. Then what we get here from this multiplication is 2x squared minus 3x minus 4. So this is actually our quotient right here, because what we were doing in the original problem was dividing by 2x minus 1. Now if we take a look at the long division, we see we've got 4x cubed minus 8x squared minus 5x plus 4 that we're dividing by 2x minus 1. So our first multiplier is going to be 2x squared, and we get 4x cubed minus 2x squared. We do the subtraction, and we get negative 8x squared plus 2x squared is negative 6x squared. Bring down the minus 5x. Our next multiplier is going to be a minus 3x. And when we multiply, we're going to get negative 6x squared plus 3x. Now we subtract. These two cancel, and we get minus 5x minus 3x is minus 8x. Bring down the 4. Then our next multiplier is going to be a minus 4, and we've got minus 4 times 2x minus 1 is negative 8x plus 4, and when we subtract, our remainder is 0. So once again, we get the same quotient, just getting it in a different way, doing it by the long division.